All right, going back to Lake D'Arbonne and hooking up with J-Man and John Godwin on a place that is like crappie heaven.
So Jay called me and said, Carl's coming back. I like old Carl. And boy, we had to find some fish because the fish this year was kind of weird. The fish are confused, the fishermen are confused, but we got out there and found some.
All right, what we have here is a miniature version of a planer board, okay?
You need a netter?
Here you go.
Oh, look at Stone go. Another chunk or two. Nice one, Jay.
So we get word that Carl's coming back, so I gotta go find some fish. I locate some fish, but there's only one problem. We have bad weather coming in. High winds, rain in the forecast, so we gotta put together a game plan.
You get the spider rigging so long, you get your casting gets kind of like it.
Yes.
But once you start doing this again, you get pinpointed back in there.
Very much so.
I got the net, but it's not out. But look, he choked that sucker.
Well, that's a nice one too. Oh, got one already. Look it. Oh. I don't need to have to grab it because he's already got it. Look.
I knew the wind. We was going to have a short window to do it with. So we opted to go do the long lining first, and boy, it paid off.
There's another one right there.
Oh.
Yeah, here you go.
All right.
That's a big one, I think. Two systems, out to the side, out to the back. Boy, oh boy. Like a lawnmower cutting grass, right?
Yep.
A wide range, great system.
We're cutting a good path. Oh.
Dalvin's got one?
I got one. I got one.
Netter?
Oh yeah, that's a good one. He's pulling dry.
Okay. Look at this. Oh, jeez, I got a fish on right there. Can you hold up for a sec, Jake? Okay. You got a fish out there? That rod there, look. Oh, it's a good crappie. That's teamwork.
So the wind got up really too much for us to manage in there long lining, and the plan was if that happened, go to the trees.
John Goblin's got a good one.
Get a net.
Want a net? Okay.
Now there's only one scenario where I allow somebody to call me a tree hugger, and this is it.
That one-on-one aspect of crappie, putting that little jig down there, holding it, waiting for the bite, you can't beat it.
You got one.
What a bite. Yes, I lost one, remember? Louisiana proud.
I'm talking them women, they can't get off of it. If you cook them this way, you'll get gas money, bait money, and possibly even boat money. Let's go to the fire and get these things cooked up.
Let's go. That's why you go crappie fishing right here. That's why you go.
This is mustard fried crappie. Compliments of Lake D'Arbonne.
I'm Karl Kalonka, and this is my job. Traveling across North America in search of the best crappie holes while hooking up with some legendary crappie fishermen and a host of colorful characters along the way. Visiting some distinctive destinations and having opportunity to sample some very unique culinary cuisine. This week, we're back in Union Parish on Lake D'Arbonne. And this year I'm back to fish with Jay Stone and John Godwin. And we're gonna do something a little bit different. Long lining. But Jay's got a system that he's going to show you that keeps the baits away from the boat, doesn't spook the crappie, and hopefully catch a big crappie. So the guys just pulled up. I'm going to get ready to head over to them, get in their boat, and have some fun. Let's go see.
So we get word that Carl's coming back, so I got to go find some fish. I locate some fish, but there's only one problem. We have bad weather coming in, high winds, rain in the forecast, so we got to put together a game plan. But I noticed early that morning, the wind was going to be light enough where we can try out our new planer board, planer cork, long lining technique.
So, well, you notice on the graph, we'd see the fish on our side image, and you'd see them, but they'd always be to the side in that shallow water, so they'd go around that boat.
Right.
It's a cork with a fin, and what that does, that allows you to get the baits away from the boat. You know, a lot of times we deal with spooky fish around here. They get hammered pretty hard. All right, what we have here is a miniature version of a planer board, okay? The crappie version. But this is a planer cork. It pretty much serves the same purpose. And we're going to be using our long lining technique. The only difference is, instead of having a rooster tail behind the boat, we're going to have a peacock tail.
Gotcha.
You know, yes. More baits in the water.
Yes.
A bigger spread.
Long lining's kind of like the crankbait of bass fishing. It's a good way to find fish real quick to see if they're there. And they're supposed to be there. And if they're there, the long lining's going to get them. And these new corks are going to spread way out. And we're really going to cover some water this year. Now I've changed my technique.
You have?
Yeah. I had last year, we had all 6-footers back here.
Yes.
But now I got 10, 8, and 6s.
Okay.
So it gives a little bit better separation.
So right off the bat, rods are out there, he's got the 10-foot, 8-foot, and an ultralight, bam, right away, Godwin catch a fish, just like before. You sure it's a fish?
Oh, yeah.
You need a net?
Come here, crappie.
Net it?
I ain't got it out.
Hey, we don't even have a net.
I got the net, but it's not out. But look, what? He choked that sucker.
Well, that's a nice one, too. Oh, Godwin already. Look it. Well, I don't need to have to grab it, because he's already got it. Look. Godwin knows crappie.
We got one!
Is that fast enough, folks?
Look how deep that is.
Wow.
Look. Oh, watch him.
Where is he?
Oh, good night. If I was in a tournament, that would give me a heart attack.
Wouldn't Jay just be like, what are you doing?
What are you doing in the world?
We didn't have a whole lot of time before that wind picked up. So I'd say hour and a half, that's about all we had. So I told Carl, I said, oh, we got to make hay while the sun's shining. So let's get out there and get after it. We got the poles out. We got the corks out. And we got on some good fish, which took a little pressure off of me.
You know what? What the? That's a crappie. And Goblin goes, take your shoes off. Take my shoes off. You know what? Fish barefoot for crappie? All right. Carl got crappie.
Crappie Carl.
Oh, he's staying down too. Is it a good one or is it a cat? Oh, look at this thing. Oh, I think that's a good crappie. Where are you? Tuck on my line. Oh no, he looks like a good one, John. The barefoot system seems to be working.
Barefoot.
I'm gonna come in between here.
Come on in here. We got him.
Nice, nice. Wow. I'm liking this.
And I have a 1/4 ounce slip sinker about a foot above that jig.
Okay.
So what that does is, when you're going 1 mile an hour, which is what we normally go long lining, you got about a 45 degree drag up underneath that cork. So if you want to fish 3 foot deep, you let out 6 foot of line.
Gotcha.
One right here. Oh, you need a netter?
Here you go.
Oh. Oh, look at Stone go. Another chunk or two. Nice one, Jay. Two systems, out to the side, out to the back. Boy, oh boy. Like a lawnmower cutting grass, right?
Yep.
Wide range. Great system.
We cutting a good path. Here.
Another one?
Yeah, I got two of them.
Uh-oh. You have to put that net down. If he's too big. Godwin's got two, I got none. How's that? And I think I'm around his tip of his rod.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. Look at this. This is something, eh, Jay?
Here.
Rod tips need to go towards me.
Yeah, come back this way a bit, John. There's one. I think that's mine, yes? Or actually it's John's, but mine. And he scoops him in the boat like a big fat bass.
We just sitting here jigging like a bunch of schoolgirls. Ain't crappie fishing fun.
Rod's going up, stumps, net, wow. If you think this is easy, you're misled, because there's a system to this. It's not just throwing the bait out the back of the boat and hopefully, you know, you're not getting stuck. Hopefully fish sees your bait. You know, it's the right size bait, line, speed, control, everything, all those elements put together, puts those fish in the boat. John, what again, you said 10 foot, 8 foot, 5 foot?
Yeah, okay. 10 foot on the ends, 8 foot in the middle, 6 foot on the inside.
Okay.
That gives you about 2 foot in between each one.
Yeah.
It's a little bit better.
Yes.
Just a little better.
See, the average guy will watch this and think, oh, they're just trolling, but you've got a lot of little things involved in the elements, right?
Right.
The size of the jig, the length of the poles, so it's not just pick up any rods and just drag them behind the boat.
No, right. You need to vary your weight on your jig head depending on the depth of water you're fishing. We're fishing 5 to 6 foot of water, so yeah, with speed too, we're using 16th ounce jig head. We used 1/32nd and 1/16th last year, and we went to all 1/16th this year because the water's up a little bit. We've had a lot of rain, so we had to use get down a little bit deeper because them fish were staging and up on the flat and staying close to the bottom.
I got Godwin's rod. I have to give him his pole again. You know why? He's got another big crappie. Oh boy, Jay, look at this. Another monster. I feel guilty of bringing it in, folks, seriously.
No, bring it in.
Okay, hear what he said? The chef said, yeah. Bring it in. Oh my goodness, Jay.
Let me know when he gets
Look at that. Oh yeah. Oh, look at him. Beautiful crappie. I'll swing him. Godwin's fish. Oh! My goodness. You talk about teamwork. Godwin's tying up my bait. See his rod go down. I lift up, and a beautiful crappie. That's what friends do for friends when you're crappie fishing.
That's right.
If he's gonna cook them and I get to eat them, at least I can help him bring them in.
You get the spider rigging so long, you get your casting gets kind of lacking.
Yes.
But once you start doing this again, you get pinpointed back in there.
Very much so. Yeah. The big one?
He feels good.
Okay.
He feels good.
Oh. I think you're over it.
He's hung up in that line. Get over here.
Look at him fight. My goodness. Come here, crappie. Oh, Lord.
You got him.
Oh, yes. Goblin's got three good ones in a row. Look at that. Man, are they beautiful fish.
Oh, that's a good one there.
Yes, sir.
I knew the wind was coming, so I had to have a backup plan. And then the backup plan was tree hugging.
Slowed down a little bit. We had two live wells full of fish. Now it's time to go cook them up. My favorite part. And this is my woman's favorite way to do it. And if you listen to me, you'll get gas money, bait money,
stuff money,
and possibly even boat money. I'm telling you. And you get a little salt.
Not too much.
Get a little salt and put it on there. A little pepper.
Nope, a lot of pepper.
Then you get your mustard. Put your mustard on. Woo! Look at that. Mustard. Now you gotta rub it in.
Don't put too much mustard.
Now you let this sit a minute while your fire's getting hot. And that's ready right there.
Make sure they're all coated.
They're coated. This is flour over here. And we're gonna put flour on them instead of cornmeal. But there's one more secret ingredient we got to go with. Corn chips. Bust them up real good, real fine. We're gonna put this in there with the flour. This is gonna give them a crispy base on the outside, give them a good crunch. Now we're not gonna put the fish in the flour till we get out there and fix them and put it in the grease.
That's right.
Because if you let it sit, it'll dough up on you and it'll be kind of doughy. You don't want to. Let's go to the fire and get these things cooked up.
All right, don't put too many in there. Don't put too many in there.
Okay. I'm going to just do it like I do it at the house.
Yeah, five at a time.
Mix it up real good. You don't want no wet ingredients before you go in the fire. You want it all dry.
Yeah, make sure you got it good and covered. Boy, you move like molasses in the wintertime.
Oh, yeah. Hey, small
you need to go fast.
Smell great oak. One of these fillets in your mouth so you can't talk back.
Two. What we got that temperature at? 400?
Well, this is a little off. It's about 370, 375. That's where you want it.
375. Mm.
Hurry up.
That's why you go crappie fishing right here. That's why you go.
This is mustard fried crappie, compliments of Lake D Arbonne.
Watch this right here. Yeah, watch it.
Well, get out of the way. Get out of the way of that sauce. I had friends over, you know, these crappie, they ain't just for the fishermen, because there's people that love to eat them, and it just brings everybody together. It's just a great time.
Trolling and stuff, you know, the winches got too rough. You just couldn't hold the boat correctly on those contour edges and stuff that Jay was putting us on, helped us catch fish. So the guys have said, we're gonna go jigging cypress trees. Was I excited? Big time. You know why? That one-on-one aspect of crappie, putting that little jig down there, holding it, waiting for the bite, you just can't beat it.
We get there and Jay loses the bet. He's got to be the tree hugger.
Now there's only one scenario where I allow somebody to call me a tree hugger. The tree hugger is responsible for one thing, keep the boat still. Because when you're telescoping these cypress trees, there's a lot of cypress knees out around those trees. If you get to drifting back and forth, you're gonna stay hung up and it's gonna be aggravating.
Reel it up just a hair, Carl, just a hair. I won't. And I drop it right down in front of that board.
Okay.
What you wanna do is pull your line up with your hand.
Yes.
To the rod tip.
Yes.
I set that right there.
On, right about.
But to the left a little bit. And just drop it straight down.
And it's about 4 feet deep? And am I fishing the bottom?
Wait, you can tell if you hit the bottom. You're going to fish right above the bottom.
Okay.
They're right on the bottom.
So you're just putting in front of his nose.
And a lot of times, these fish will be on the outside edges because these cypress tree roots, they go all the way to the edge of the limb.
So you're fishing all the way like out here too?
Yeah.
Okay, gotcha.
Well, we started out at a couple spots where I normally catch them pretty good, and we zeroed. Didn't catch a fish. And I was thinking to myself, I didn't let them know it, but I was a little bit nervous. So we eased on around the corner at a couple other spots, a good little grove of cypress trees. We eased up in there, I grabbed the limb, and I look over there, Godwin got him about a 16-incher while I'm hooking the tree.
Well, look at that. John Godwin's got a good one.
Get a net.
Want a net? Okay, can you hold that for a second?
Set it down the boat.
Okay, I'm coming, John. He's got a bull. Oh my goodness. Look at Godwin's crappie.
Get the net.
Hold that one to the camera. My goodness. You are not kidding. They're big in here, huh?
So first thing, up to a tree, I get me a big one. Jay's just up there. That's what we're looking for right there.
Wow.
Look at the eggs in there.
That's a big fish, man.
Mm.
Beautiful crappie.
And then I look over there and Carl's, he's got about a 14-incher while I'm hugging the tree.
There we go.
Got it?
Yep. Look at that.
Weaving through the bushes.
Son of a gun, huh? Is that fun or what? And then you come back, find a way to get him into the boat. And there's Jay Stone. Oh.
He come off.
Yeah. He got on, but he wasn't hooked very good.
Did you pop him off on me?
You know what happened?
What happened?
These Canadian guys won't set the hook on him.
He was fine until he grabbed my line. That's my excuse.
So I wedged that boat up in between them trees and that dock, and I said, all right, boys, tree hugging time is over. I'm fixing to catch me some fish.
Man, hurry.
Oh, good night. There's a bull. Look at that.
Wow. Golly.
Hey, you got to hold that tree.
Oh, good. Yeah, I'll hold a tree. You guys are doing it.
Skin hook. I had her skin hook.
Really?
I mean, barely. I barely felt the bump.
That's a bull right there.
That's a big crappie, dude.
Yeah, look at the head, look at the mouth on that sucker.
Looks like a bass. Wow.
Don't throw it. Quit sliming me.
Look at the size of that fish, man. Son of a gun.
Tree hugging has its perks. sometimes.
Oh, a netter? Oh, yeah. Yeah. Yep.
You got the net back.
I'm trying to get it. You got one.
What a bite. Yes, I lost one, remember? Louisiana proud. Wow. Just hold it, and all of a sudden, eh? Wow, Jay. You guys got it down to a T, man. Seriously, John, that's psychotic, dude.
I don't know.
Look at the size of them, too, in here. Wow.
A good one.
D Arbonne on the cypress trees.
Well, I didn't really know what to expect with the bad weather coming in, but once again, things worked out great. We found the fish. We caught them using multiple techniques, and we had a great time, great fellowship, and some pretty good eating.
You know, catching big crappie is a lot of fun, but something about coming to Lake D Arbonne in Union Parish, it's the people, the places, and just meeting all the tourist people to put this together and stuff. It's the whole package that usually attracts me to a crappie destination. When they're big fish, yeah, I love it. So when we go to a destination like that, we're making memories that are gonna last a lifetime. And right here on Lake D Arbonne, that's what we accomplished once again. And a very big thanks to the Union Parish Tourist Commission and Union Parish Chamber of Commerce. A very special thanks to the D Arbonne Point for providing first-class accommodations. Visit them at darbonnepoint.com to book your vacation. Crappie Kings Television, presented by B&M Poles. Wherever fishing takes you, B&M has been there. Strike King Lure Company, Power Pole, Shallow Water Anchors. Visit us at crappiekings.com.